I will begin a presentation from now on. The title of the paper is Development of Measuring a Tool for Terminal Care Performance. First of all, I will tell you about the necessary of research. In Korea, the population of the population Sorry, in Korea, the proportion of the population aged 65 years or older to the total population has continued to increase due to the low birth rate and aging population, and is predicted to research 30% by 2030 and 40% by 2060, making Korean society to be a super-aged society. An increase in the elderly population is leading to an increase in the use of medical service by them, and in the elderly deaths in hospital, through an increase in demand for medical service for the elderly and in patient with geriatric disease. The care for elderly patient at home is difficult due to the prevalence of nuclear family and increased society and professional activities of family members, forcing the care for and death of elderly to occur in hospital. The provision of terminal care by medical personnel in other countries has also been shown to reduce the number of emergency hospitalization and to alleviate a family suffering and burden on medical provider. This phenomenon indicates that the center of terminal care is shifted from family to medical personnel, and the role of hospital nurses in terminal care is becoming more important. Terminal care performance is to help the terminally ill patient to die with decency and comfort while maintaining human dignity. One of the important rule of nurse is to care for patients who are dying in the last stage of life, and to help them face death positively. The nurse is caring for terminally ill patients, however, may experience difficulties in terminal care performance due to psychological pain, such as feeling of helplessness or death anxiety and hopelessness that there is nothing they can do to save the patient's life. It is necessary to lower the terminal care stress of nurses in order to increase efficiency, since terminal care performance may be overloaded. It may be difficult for terminal care nurses who face the patient's death more closely than anyone else to perform the terminal care required. According to each hospital's policy and each patient, due to the lack of awareness of death and stress. Most of the studies on terminal care so far has increased in intensive care unit nurses, hospice nurses, and clinical nurses as subject. The subject of study on hospital nurses increased the relationship between terminal care stress and death perception. Terminal care related stress and degree of terminal care performance. For the Korean scale for degree of terminal care performance, the one developed by Park and Choi has been used until now. In foreign countries, studies from Pishi and Shelley as nursing activities based on spiritual nursing, based on religious belief to promote hospital nurses to terminal care performance for terminal patients have prepared for terminal care performance. It has been the basis for this. Recently, the concept of nursing pursues holistic nursing in consideration of physiology, body, social, culture, and psychological aspects while providing overall nursing care for patients. Although 20 years have passed since the development of the scale for degree of terminal care performance, there has been no study on the measurement of the degree of terminal care performance or the development of the terminal care performance measurement scale suitable for a situation in Korea. Considering this situation, the development of the terminal care performance measurement scale suitable for the current clinical environment is an urgent task. The purpose of this study was therefore to develop a scale to measure the degree of terminal care performance in hospital nurse. I will tell you a research method. This is the Delphi research study. For the development of a scale to measure the degree of terminal care performance in hospital nurses that identify the component of the scale and reach a collective agreement, though the review by expert group. In the Delphi study, the formation of a panel of experts is necessary, and in this study, the panel of expert groups was consist of clinical nurses who had a career over 7 years and even experience as a terminal care nurse in hospital. For the first round Delphi survey, a total of 20 nurses were recruited. Seven nurses worked for two generation hospital in S area and five nurses works for two general hospital in D data. The development scale was repeatedly revised after being reviewed by a panel of experts what item to be deleted, collected, and edited were continually objected. Finally, 50 items were developed. The developed items were divided following the agreement among experts into three periods before dying, during dying, and after dying, based on the time when terminal care was provided. The development questionnaire was administered to 16 clinical nurses for the second Delphi survey. This study was approved by the Bioethics Committee of the Research Institution. During the interview, consent was obtained for the recording, and after sufficiently explaining the research content to the expert group, voluntary consent was obtained and the research was conducted. It was explained that the information obtained during the research process is used only for the research and is permanently deleted at the end of the research. It was explained that all information obtained the research is encrypted and managed. The focus group interview to develop the Delphi survey item was conducted from January 15 to April 13, 2020, repeat review on the item were conducted until May 15, 2021, when the confirmation of the panel of expert and component for item development, the content validity of each item of the scale with the composition complete was reviewed during the second Delphi survey from May 15, 2021 to June 13. I will tell you about data analysis. The first item development was conducted through expert panel interview and open ended questionnaire, and the second Delphi survey was with a completed questionnaire. For the second Delphi and data analysis, IBM SPSSWin 2623 program was used. Frequency and percentage, mean and standard deviation were analyzed, and content validity was measured by calculating CVR for each item. Kendall's W was calculated to check the degree of agreement of the expert panel on all questionnaire. The CVR indicates the percentage of experts who answered that the questionnaire was appropriate. In this study, it was calculated at the proportion of respondents who responded with 4 or 5 points on a 5-point scale. The CBR calculation formula is as follows. I will tell you about the research result. Table 2 shows the result of the Delphi survey that confirmed the terminal care performance of clinical nurses conducted in clinical nurses. Of the total 50 items, 46 items were found to have content validity about the criteria value for both performance and importance, so they were judged to be appropriate as an item for the terminal care performance of clinical nurses, especially the item to show highest points for clinical care performance were after preparing terminal care supplies. I can put on disposable glove and remove the monitor and into a patient device attached to the body. In the final scale for degree of terminal care performance, 46 items were included except for item 1, 17, 35, and 36, whose content validity was below the criteria. I will tell you about a discussion. All nurses, regardless of their work department, experience the death of patients, and it is more for those working in intensive care units, hematology, oncology departments, and hospice ward. The nursing department curriculum, however, seems insufficient to prepare nurses for such experience. Some nurses may not learn terminal care unit until they graduate from nursing college because terminal care course is set as elective subjects rather than compulsory subject. In addition, there is a tendency for the terminal care to be treated as relatively less important compared to other causes related to disease treatment and drug therapy. For that reason, now nursing who start working in an unprepared state are inevitably embarrassed by the death of patients they encounter at the hospital. Furthermore, few hospitals provide systematic training on terminal care to nurse. As a result, nurses have a perception that terminal care is difficult, and they often hear about terminal care from senior nurses. Empirically and indirectly or rarely on doctor's prescription. Patient death is natural, and patients want to maintain their human dignity even the moment of death. Nurse is essential role in terminal care because nurses do their best in their duties. Providing terminal care of a high level to patients increases their job satisfaction as well. Therefore, nurses want to receive systematic guideline and education on terminal care. If these expectations are not met, nurses find themselves performing terminal care like a machine without any emotion and avoid to be involved in terminal care. Some studies have shown that provision of the terminal care education for nursing studies and nurses have a positive effect. The study development of measurement scale to confirm the provision of high quality terminal care in hospital nurses. To clarify the content of terminal care and materialize terminal care practice in clinical practice. Though the developed scale for degree of terminal care performance item were developed by a panel consisted of clinical nurses. In addition, while the item of the existing scale were general and abstract, the development one composed of very concise and clear performance oriented practical item. I will tell you conclusion. The result of this study expect to be utilization in the development of end-of-life nursing education program that improve job satisfaction of hospital nurses by alleviating their burden due to terminal care and allowing them to provide terminal care suitable for the patient's situation. Thank you for your attention.